in a minute, but I saved this particular guy for last for a lot of reasons. I saved him to last for a lot of reasons. We had to give him time to get woke up. Had to get him time. This morning he lost one section of his teeth. Had to get him time to find his teeth and get on in here. You've heard singers say from this platform, and I've heard Rodney say this many times, how much Ed O'Neill means to a lot of these singers you see on this platform. A lot of them have gone to the Ed O'Neill University of Gospel Singing. And Ed, I don't know if you really ever, I'm sure you do, but I don't know if you ever really sit down and grasp what an impact. Of course, you have a great impact on stage, but what an impact you've had in these young guys' lives that have caused them to want to sing this music that you've sung for so long. And one of the guys you've really influenced is this guy who stands next to me all the time. Not a day goes by that your name doesn't come up and he shares a story of something that happened on the Dixie Melody Boys bus, or he tells me something that you said to him, giving him some kind of wisdom, even in a funny way. It still stuck with him, you know. And when I thought of a song that we could do with Ed, I thought of how long he'd been singing and how long I've been singing, how long we want to sing. And we had to do this song with Ed. And we've never rehearsed this song together or anything. As a matter of fact, he recorded in the studio separate from us because of our schedules. And it has a vocal intro. And so we're going to have to be right on it when I count it. So I'm going to go down. You stand up, old man. Take your time. Right, there's our pitch. I'm going to count down from three, and then we're going to sing. All right, Ed? hallelujah, the sweeter he grows. Thank you, Mark. God bless you.
The more that I love you, more joy.